Hello everyone. This video will be on the automation of Firefox web browser. Okay, so I'll be automating Firefox web browser by using Selenium and PowerShell. So in order to start the automation, you need to have two things. One is the Selenium and the second is the Firefox web driver. Okay. So how we can do this? We can download these two things from the two different websites. So these websites are here. Okay, you can download the Selenium browser from the from this website. You can go, you can open this link, and you can go and click here in the download package. Okay. You can see that download has started, and for the sake of this video, means I have already downloaded these files in another video. In a separate folder. Let me open that folder first. And the second driver, that is the driver for Firefox, you can download from this website. So I'll be giving you the link in the description box to download these two files. One is this is driver and this is generally AXE. So you have to download the Firefox driver as per your operating system. Okay, mine is Windows 64, so I'm will download this driver. It is called Geeko driver, I think. But it has already been downloaded. So I've created a separate folder for that. So I have already downloaded these two files, okay, in a separate folder exclusively for this purpose, for the purpose of automation. So I created a folder in my F drive, and this is a separate folder for this Firefox automation. Okay, so now next step will be to unzip this. I'll unzip. Now it is unzipped. Now I'll also extract this also. It is extracted. Now what I have to do is I have to go and pick the webdriver.dll file. Okay, so as per your .NET installed on your system, so this is the version of .NET installed in my system. I'm going to copy this file and paste it here. Here we have the web browser, Firefox web browser driver. Copy it and paste it here. Okay, now we are going to, means these are the two things which two files which we should have before the starting of the automation. Okay, so I have already downloaded it. Now let's start. So first step is to import the DLL. So how we can do it? We can import the DLL by using this servlet import module, and then you have to give the address of the DLL file, which is F Selenium test Firefox folder. Okay, and now you have to give the DLL file name. Okay, now once it is I have given the full address, now let me run it. So I have run it. Nothing will happen here, but now I can use, means I can show you why I have run it. You will come to realize. So the next step is to perform, to use another cmdlet, which is called new object. Okay, and then open qa.selenium.firefox.firefox driver. Okay, and I'll be storing, this is an object, so I'll be storing it in a variable called Firefox driver. Okay, and the next step will be to Firefox driver, means the next step will be to what this will do till here, what it will do, it will open the Firefox browser. Okay, and nothing, there will be nothing, there will be no search criteria, anything, nothing. Okay, so let me show you. You can see that it has opened the Firefox browser. but there is nothing. Okay, there is no Google Chrome, nothing. Okay, so the next step will be to show you what happened, what will happen. Next step will be to, I have to open, there you would have seen that there is no URL in the search box, means in the URL box, sorry. So how we can do it is by using method called navigate, then another method called go to URL, and then type giving the URL, which is www.google.com. this case. Okay, now let's see what happens. You can see here now that whatever I have written here, it has been opened. That page is open. Now we have the Google Chrome. Okay, now the next step will be to enter something here in the search box, which will be I will be searching, also in there any search criteria. So I will be searching my channel PowerShell Experiments, YouTube channel. Okay, so it will give this. Okay, and then I will be clicking this. So this will give the my channel page. Okay, so I am going to automate all this process. So the first thing which I will be going to do is I will be typing here in the input box. I will be giving the search criteria. So how I can do that? Let me open a separate web page, Firefox web browser. Okay. So and let me close this first. And also you can see whether your automation is running or not by clicking here, by going here. You can see that this is giving the message browser is under remote control. Okay, it means that we are this web browser is being run by script. Okay, so let me close it first. And let me open the Google Chrome. Now, second criteria will be to enter here, enter and search criteria here. But here you can see that how PowerShell will identify this box, and how after that how it will type the search criteria. First of all, you should know that a web page, okay, contains a lot of elements. Okay, for example, this is an element, this is an element, this is an element, this box, this button is an element. Everything is an element. Okay. So you have to uniquely identify each of the element, and then there will be certain methods and properties associated with those elements. Okay, so first, our first criteria will be to identify these elements. How we can identify? Click here and then right click and go to this inspect. Okay, you can see that the code for this is this highlighted portion. Okay, now you can see we can identify an element by a number of methods. We have a number of methods to identify element uniquely, namely, or you can say most common one is the by class name, by class, by ID. Okay, these are basically tags. Okay, so you can see that here we have class here. So what I'll be doing is I will be using this class to locate this element in this web page, because this web page contains a lot of other elements. So you can see here that this is one of the element. Okay, and you can see that there are a number of other elements above and below this highlighted code. Okay, so let me copy this class first. I have copied this class. Now I will use another method called XPath. Okay, XPath to locate this element uniquely, because it is possible that there can be multiple elements with the same class name. So we'll find it here. Okay, so how we can use class XPath? By this double slashes, then star, then square braces at class is equal to then you have to mention the criteria in the search box. Now let's see. Here you can see that it is uniquely identified. This is because it is only one, means this class name is associated with only one element, and that is this input box. How you can verify if there would have been two or more than two, sorry, one or more than one, then there would have been a number greater than one. Okay, either it, the number would have been 2 or 3, 4, 5, depending on the how many elements having the same class. Okay, so we may come across certain with this scenario later on. Okay, so I'm going to copy this. Okay, and now let's get back to the our ISC here. Now the next step is to identify that element, and then we have to write something on that element. So how I will tell PowerShell that it is this element you have to search by this. Find element. Yes, I told you that there are a number of methods to search different objects or web elements here. So you can see that this is class name, CSS selector by ID, link name by name. Okay, so this is we need. Okay, so by this method I will tell PowerShell that this is the element, and means you have to search the element by XPath, and this is the element which you have to search. It is giving this this sign. So this is because there are double braces, so you have to invert give single inverted commas here. Okay, now it is okay. Now it has identified. Now what it has to do, it has to write the search criteria. So how you will do it? By using this method called send keys. Here I will be giving this address. Sorry, this search criteria I will be entering. That is, I have to search PowerShell experiments YouTube. Okay. So let me run, and now let's see what happens. Okay. Let me run the script. Here you can see that it has entered. Now after entering, what I have to do, I have to submit it, or I have to press enter, or I have to do this Google search. Okay, so how I can do it is by using the submit method. Okay, so next thing will be to submit. So Firefox again, and doing the let me copy this whole of this line here till here. Okay, copy, and then here, and then you have to give the method, means what you want to do. So I want to submit this to Google. Okay, so I have submitted. Now let's see what happens. You can see that this has it has opened this channel. Okay, it has given the results, sorry, search results, and my channel is at the second number. Okay, so let me close it again, and now my next step will be to identify this element. Okay, let me close it. So how I am going to do that? I am again going to use the same method. Let me clicking on the hyperlink. So how are you doing this? First of all, I will be identifying, and I'll be using the same code here. Okay. The only thing will change is this element which we have to search. This is because this web page is different. Okay, now let me locate. Let me first search here in normal browser, experiments YouTube. Now this is my website, sorry, this is my channel actually. So let me highlight it, so you can see that this is the element that I have to look for, and it has also a class name. So let me copy this class name and let me verify whether this same class name is associated with this element only or it has other elements also. So how I can do it? Again, by doing the using the same path, that is same method, sorry, XPath, then this now here you can see that this class name is not uniquely associated with this only. This is because you can see that there are 10 elements, 10 web elements which are having this same class name. Okay. So let's see. Just press enter. This is the number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again 1 and then this is 2. So how we can uniquely identify this out of the 10 elements? This is at the place number 2. Okay, how it is, how you know that it is number 2? This is because this is giving the number and then this 2. Now you can see that it is uniquely identified. So I will copy it and then so I have to paste it here. Okay, and then what I have to do, I have to click it. Okay, now let's see what happens. Okay, I have to insert some delay. Okay, let me insert some delay. Let me first insert a delay of 5 seconds. Now let us run again. You can see that it has opened the website. Okay, sorry, it has opened the YouTube channel. Okay, so let me close it again manually. Now you can see that I am closing the web browser as well as the driver manually. So you can also close this by this script also. This can also be closed by a script. So how we can do it? By using this method called close. Sorry, close and then to close the browser, to close the web driver, if we can use this method, quit. Okay, now let's start again. So you can see that it has closed automatically. So this was the whole process on how to automate Firefox. Okay, so you can see that how easy it is. So if you really find it useful, if you really find my work matters, and please give a thumbs up and please share and subscribe to my channel. And also if you have any questions, then please mention those questions in the comment box and I will get back to you. Till then, till my next video, take care. Bye.